My notion of public service has been, what can I do all along the way to hopefully make, based on my decisions, life better for the next generation. And hopefully they'll see some of that in the papers. Hopefully they'll see the lessons learned, some good, some bad, mistakes made. There's a lot to be withdrawn from, I think, our archives, and hopefully it will be of use to students and perhaps future leaders.
It was always important for me to preserve as much of the documents, especially as it relates to Tom's governing. He has a very unusually broad scope of experience in public service, and I think it was important for all those different aspects to be represented.
When students and scholars and professors, they all have the opportunity to review the documents relating to my time as governor, I hope it reflects, at least in my view, not only the challenges associated with governing, but there's a certain art to governing. So it was balancing the responsibilities of governing, and I was pretty much 7 day a week governor. I loved it. I mean, I just loved being gov. Everything associated with it, a lot of intellectual and emotional satisfaction out of having the job. And I wanted to make Pennsylvania a leader among states and a competitor among nations. And so if you're looking at education reform, tax reform, social reform, technology reform, whatever, that's the threshold. We needed to get over that. Whatever that that innovation or new approach we're going to take, I wanted us to make a leader, make a difference. And that you tie that all up together, and it's about the art of governing in order to achieve an outcome you think will benefit your constituents.
I think part of what I realize is that the primary and secondary research sources are important for people going back and trying to determine, you know, what motivated someone in public service, why they made the sort of decisions and why they governed the way they did, and that is, besides the public record and especially the media coverage, you really need to go back and look at primary and secondary and tertiary documents to have the whole picture. I knew the first time I met him he was going to be somebody, and that was a long time ago. But I think for me it was really a case of, because he is a very thoughtful person, and even his letters, personal letters, show a lot about how deeply he thinks about things. And so I always felt very conscious that I needed to keep some of his materials, not everything, but in order to have an insight into who Tom Ridge is.
In October, we announced the donation of the Ridge collection and the fact that Mercyhurst was holding it with a small gala. And we also did an exhibition at that time. This is just one of the many wonderful, important, and original materials. This is the only one of its kind, so we have to take very good care of it. It's been sealed in Mylar and then given this outside matting.
Well, I'm very proud of my home community of Erie, Pennsylvania. You know, there are a couple of venues in Erie, Pennsylvania that are technically named after me, but every time I drive by them and I tell my friends, you really need to think of my father and my mother, Tom and Laura Ridge, because my dad was given the opportunity to move on a couple of occasions into management, but he said, no, I want to raise my family in Erie. The broader reach of the university was just very appealing to me, and frankly, they were very generous in extending the offer, and it just seemed to be a perfect arrangement. So, a great university in my hometown that had a curriculum in many instances around some of the things that were very important to me, and more important, very important to the country.
He grew up in Erie, and his roots are in Erie, and Northwestern Pennsylvania has been incredibly generous to Tom Ridge and to Tom Ridge's family. So I think it was always a consideration that we needed to think about where our home was, where our roots are. And I think Mercyhurst, because of its innovative and entrepreneurial spirit and the intelligence analyst studies, it was a really good combination, and it made a lot of sense.
I want to acknowledge the family and friends' gratitude for Mercyhurst taking on the task of sorting through whatever many public records are, given the my time in public service and put him in a way that hopefully will be relevant to students and scholars and researchers. So we're very grateful to the Mercyhurst family for adopting the Ridge family and friends that provided the papers.